guys. We're here today with Emma Owen. And Emma, if you want to just start by briefly introducing yourself, who you are, what role do you have?
Well, I have many different roles, but I started at the Message Trust 25 years ago. I was only 10. And I was a member of the Worldwide Message Tribe, so I was a rapper and a break dancer in a hip-hop band. But things have changed. We've now got 10 other bands that my husband Tim, who was also in the band, heads up. My official role is the Northwest Hub Leader for the whole of the Message Trust, but I'm also the founder and manager of Respect Me, which is a PSHE program where we have six teams in four countries helping schools to look at those tricky topics around relationships and sex and identity. So I have a great job, and as anything in the message, you get to do everything. So we've got big festival Manchester coming up, so I'm heading up all the women's outreach, got loads of fantastic events, so I'm a busy bee.
So next question is, were you invested in as a young person, and how did that impact your personal development?
To be honest, it saddens me to say probably no. I had a great mum who loved God, loved the Bible. I was brought up in a Church of England. So yeah, there would have been Sunday school. We'd hear some great stories and play some games when I was really young. But then I moved to a free church in my early teens, and everybody met together. And it was great worship, it was great investment. But I never had that youth group. I never had that youth leader. So to be honest with you, by the time I was 16 and I'd left school and I got my job up in London, and I learned that you could go down the pub at lunchtime, you could go to the nightclub in the evenings, I think I definitely had the label of being a Christian, but not the lifestyle. And possibly because I didn't have that youth leader who I was accountable to, or someone who was teaching me how to live out my faith. I had the knowledge of what faith was, but not how to live it out. So in other words, I wasn't discipled, so I didn't know how to make good choices. I made a lot of bad choices. Hence Respect Me, because now I can talk about it.
Yeah, exactly.
So learn from my mistakes and don't learn the hard way.
So then what advice would you give to someone in a position of influence, so with regards to passing on knowledge to young people?
Go for it. Be intentional. Be proactive. You know, if you've got information, if you've got experience, if you love Jesus, if you're an evangelist, invest into the next generation. We are all role models from the moment we're born, really. You know, I talk to young kids. I've got like a 10-year-old. Ever since she was young, I'm like, everyone who's younger than you looks up to you. And so anyone can be that role model of any age. If you can speak, you can participate, and you can give off what you've experienced. And I would just say, particularly in church, you know what, let's invest into the next generation. You know, I find it's quite interesting. Some churches have all the age groups together. Yeah. So all the 9-year-olds, all the 10-year-olds, but then it goes on. You know, the 18s to 30s are together, the 40 to 50-year-olds are together. But we need to learn from those who are older and wiser. You know, I love sitting down with someone in their 80s, yeah. You know, learning about their life, what their struggles were. And we come from two different worlds, but I can learn so much from them, and they can learn from me as well. So we need to invest. We need to pass the baton on, and we need to educate so that, like I said earlier, people aren't learning the hard way. They're not reinventing the wheel. Mm-hmm. If it's not broke, don't fix it. But let's invest into the next generation so that they can soar further than we ever have.
Yeah, perfect. Mm-hmm. Okay, and then off the back of that, then what advice would you give to a young person seeking advice?
Just grab it. Don't just sit back and expect it to turn up on your seat. I think so often we can moan. I've been there, I've done that. Oh, no one's ever invested into me. No, I haven't got anyone that I'm accountable to. No one's actually taught me how to read the Bible or how to study the Bible. And that might be the case, but what happens is the reason becomes an excuse why we're not on fire for God and why we're not pushing forward. And we don't want anyone to be in that place. So find someone that you trust, an adult that you trust, that has a good faith, who is a Bible-believing Christian, who's full of the Holy Spirit, and say, would you spend some time with me? Once a month, can we meet for a coffee? Get someone investing into you. Get into that youth group. I'm saying to my son all the time, you can't just sit at home in your man cave all the time. You're not going to grow. Get to that youth group. And it's hard, you know what I mean? Yeah. If you're on your own and you don't know anybody, to throw yourself in the deep end can be tricky, but it's so worth it. And I think from my history, I've not been invested into. That's why I'm really passionate. And with respect me, going from being in a band, being the blatant evangelist, saying this is the gospel that's going to change your life, then recognizing, yes, you might change your life in a split second, but actually discipleship, sanctification takes time. We need to learn how to live out our Christian lifestyle. Mm-hmm. And that's what Respect Me is all about, going into schools. How do we make good choices in these situations? How do I find out my true identity in God? Because when I can work out my own relationship, my relationship sets the tone with all other relationships. So if I know that I'm fearfully and wonderfully made, if I know I'm a daughter of the King, that I'm royalty, co-heirs with Christ, whoa, come on, check me out. Then I can have that security to go into other relationships and demand that respect and value as well, mm-hmm. so that I'm making better, healthy choices for myself, but also respecting the value in other people. And it just is that springboard, isn't it? Let's help each other to make those good choices so that we can be whole. Because at the end of the day, we're selling a product as Christians, aren't we? We're all to be evangelists. We're selling a product that God saves and can change your life. Mm-hmm. But if we're not sorted, no one's going to want to be like us. And that's what a Christian is, to be Christ-like. So we need to seek God with all our heart. Get your head stuck in the Bible. Take some time out praying. Get yourself into a youth group. Find that person that you're accountable to. Find someone who's older and wiser than you. Believe it or not, there are people out there. But yeah, go for it. Don't sit back and just say, whoa, the world is not helping me. Get out and grab it.
Perfect. Yeah, that's lots of great advice. So thank you so much for joining us. And yeah, make sure to check out Respect Me, Festival Manchester, The Message Trust. And yeah, thank you very much for joining us, Emma.
You are so welcome anytime.
Thanks.